With three races in the books, the fleur-de-lis has been waving proudly as Quebec drivers have raced their way to the top step of the podium. Andrew Ranger drove his Mopar Dodge to victory at race one, while Alex Tagliani cruised to the top step at Sunset. Last time out at Autodrome Chaudière, Alex LeBay outdueled Caden Lapcevich for his first NASCAR victory. Circuit ICAR is the next step in the journey towards the NASCAR Pinty's Championship. Welcome to Circuit ICAR for the Ecko Unlimited 100 from Mirabel, Quebec. I'm Dave Bradley, along with Adam Ross and Clinton Jeffrey, Tanya Bodain, both covering the action trackside for us here today. Adam, ICAR is our second of five road course stops this season. It's unique in its own way.
Dave, it's an airport circuit over 3.4 kilometers with 16 turns. It's a technical facility with many challenges. They have a drag strip, they have two kart tracks, and they have numerous corporate events at this facility.
And since it is an airport circuit, it's very flat. Drivers have a pretty difficult time with reference points. It's a short 30-lap race here today, no pit stops. You have to get up and go. And one driver who has done just that is 16-year-old Caden Lapcevich from Grimsby, Ontario. The youngster has two second-place finishes and a fourth-place finish this year. He's led a bunch of laps all season. Consistency has him leading the points.
And Dave, this is their biggest challenge to date. The team needs to keep it up, and they need some corporate help to maintain this strong running. Today, the 76 machine starts in the 15th spot.
With more on how the cars lined up, let's send it down to Clinton.
Alex LeBay comes into today fresh off his first NASCAR win. He drove his Can-Am Ford to a new track record in E3 qualifying. Alex, let's talk about the day. Your season didn't start on the best of notes, but now it seems momentum is on your side. What's your game plan for this afternoon?
Yeah, our Can-Am Ford has a pretty good momentum. Like you're saying, we got tripled in four races, so we got the speed. We just got to stay up there. We got a lot of fast cars behind us. They're going to be good on the long run. We got to be better than them, so it's going to be along there trying to save our stuff as much as we can and be there at the end.
All right, thanks, Alex. Starting second here tonight will be Andrew Ranger. Andrew, you know your way around this track very well. You've got a couple of young guns starting behind you in the form of Lacroix and Arsenault. You can't afford to be patient today. What's your game plan going into this afternoon?
You know what? I don't know, actually. Those guys were pushing really hard, too. So my goal is to put that Mopar pencil in front and try to do my best today. Be patient and try to pass at the end.
Guys, keep your eyes on this Mopar team. Andrew has three wins here at ICAR. He's definitely going to be one of the guys to keep your eye on this afternoon.
There's a good look at the 03 Ecko Unlimited machine of Eli Arsenault. Eli there talking to his father, Mark, and the rest of his family.
And he'll start alongside the 74 of Kevin Lacroix, but one guy who is in need of a break today, the 59 of Gary Clute. Tanya Bodain is trackside with him.
Thanks, guys. Gary, the three first races have not been your best, but you did practice well, and you qualified on fifth position. Do you feel the luck has changed this weekend?
I hope so. I think we blew up all our engines in the first race and a rear end last weekend, so hopefully the racing gods are good to us this weekend. But I think, yeah, we'll have a good car for the long run, fifth place here. Usually end up being the best qualified guy from Ontario, so I'm surrounded by all these guys from Quebec, so hopefully they treat me nice and we have a good finish. Hopefully a podium, if not a win.
Well, good luck for this weekend. And guys, remember, this is a family affair this weekend, as Gary's father, Peter Clute, is going to start from row number 7.
And there is a good look at Peter, the man behind legendary motor car, a veteran road racer in Canada. Patrick Dussault getting ready for today's race, as are the rest of the drivers. We'll be back for the drop of the green. The Ecko Unlimited 100 from the International Center of Advanced Racing is brought to you by Mopar, authentic performance. By Leland Industries, a proud Canadian fastener company. By Honeygoo, by CleanFlow, a honey of a lube. And by Alpine Stars.
Well, Dave, it is a great day for racing as we have a look at the Spectra Premium number 04 Dodge of Jean-Francois Dumoulin.
Anthony Simone back in action in the number 95 Dodge. Let's head down to Dominic Fougère with today's command.
Spectra Premium, Matteo Aguilar, prononcez les mots les plus célèbres du sport automobile, messieurs.
drivers getting the thumbs up to crank over those big engines as the Mopar Dodge Avenger Ranger fires to life. There's a good look at the 18 of Alex Taglianni.
Taglianni looking for a great run today. He's got a win already on an oval course this year.
And he has been on pole here at Circuit ICAR. Actually, he sat on the pole for the inaugural race back in 2011.
We look down at Larry Jackson, reports that that car is stuck in reverse.
Oh, and that's heartbreak for the Pilati number 8 of Larry Jackson as the field rolls off behind the Dodge Challenger pace car. Alex LeBay, your pole sitter, Andrew Ranger will roll off second.
In row number 2, Kevin Lacroix and Ely Arsenault.
And then we look back to row number 3. That's where we find Gary Clute in the 59 and Alex Taglianni in the number 18. Patrick Dussault is in the 71, and LP Dumoulin drives the 47.
Row number 5 brings us to Jean-Francois Dumoulin in the 04 in the Castrol Edge Dodge of DJ Kennington.
Looking back to row number 6, that's Jason Hathaway, driver of the 3, and Kerry Mix in the 4, the 02.
Row 7, Peter Clute in the 42 and Simon Dionvien in the 37. Starting in the 8th row, our points leader, Caden Lapsevich in the fast line Dodge and Anthony Simone in the 95.
Row number 9 is where we find Kevin Poitras in the number 1, Adam Martin, driver of the 9. And looking back to row number 10, Larry Jackson in the 8 and Raymond Gay making his first start in the number 20.
Starting 21st, Jocelyn Fecto in the 77 and David Michaud in the 40. Row 12 has Josh Collins, our driver from Newfoundland, behind the wheel of the 25.
And as we mentioned, transmission problems on the 8 of Larry Jackson. The crew working feverishly to try and get that fixed. Jackson fired, and he grabs a forward gear, stalls it, but it looks like he'll be able to roll off.
This Pilati number 8 is the third entry from the Canada's Best Racing Team stables. Canadian Red Cross on the car for Larry Jackson as well.
So the field lining up as we ride on board Alex Taglianni. Have a look at the E3 Spark Plugs race analysis.
The big thing to me today, Dave, very comfortable weather as opposed to the 2 days before this where we had extreme heat and chilly cold. This is perfect conditions.
And Adam, this is really a sprint race. It's 30 laps, no pit stops for these drivers. It's one of 3 times this season they won't have to make a stop. Before we head to the start, let's check in with Clinton one more time for the Leland lead up to the green.
Well, the Dumoulin competition team racing with heavy hearts here today. They are racing in support of Cancer Quebec Foundation. They've had some close friends and relatives who suffered from the disease. Fans got an opportunity to sign the back end of these cars, and the donations are going directly to the foundation. A great thing that the Dumoulin boys are doing here for the Cancer Foundation of Quebec.
And there's a good look at JF Dumoulin. You see LP Dumoulin just starting ahead as we'll ride on board the WeatherTech.ca number 47. The field lining up side by side as we prepare for green. 30 laps here at Circuit ICAR.
The starts here at ICAR are always hairy, Dave. Turn 1 is a tight hairpin, and the drop of the green flag, you got 23 stock cars charging into the corner.
And we'll have several angles from Andrew Ranger and Kevin Lacroix. 3 different cameras on board both of those machines. As you see the NASCAR pace car, the Dodge Challenger SRT Hellcat leading them slowly, the field bunching up nicely as they make their way through the final turns. The pace car wheels off. It's Alex LeBay in the 32, Andrew Ranger in the 27 looking for green on turn number 16. It's up and we're underway in the Ecko Unlimited 100.
Alex LeBay with a great start. Patrick Dussault 4 wide into turn number 1.
Gary Clute get pushed sideways. We got problems. Peter Clute almost around, and Caden Lapsevich, your points leader, involved.
Wow, a lot of drivers forced way offline. Jocelyn Fecto with the hood of that race car nearly coming off, but Alex LeBay with a great start. He leads in the early going.
Andrew Ranger in the Mopar Dodge keeping him honest in the early going here. The 74 of Kevin Lacroix holding down third.
And you hear them slow down through that left-hand turn. Then it's onto the long back straightaway.
And you can see the rubber buildup on this concrete surface. That's something we should mention, too. These drivers, these cars, normally run on asphalt circuits, so concrete, a little bit slippery.
We should also mention the back straightaway at ICAR. Not really straight at all, but very, very fast. Look how deep in the field Caden Lapsevich, he was second last when they came out of turn 2 after having to avoid the spun-out Clute machine.
Oh, the EpiPen Chevy of Alex Taglianni getting a nose underneath the 71 of Patrick Dussault. And Taglianni will take the spot. Dusso going to try and slam the door on Gary Clute, but Clute looking to follow him through.
And word from the officials, the 71 of Dusso is being penalized. He went three wide before they got to the start-finish line on the start. That's a no-no, Dave, and the penalty is a drive through the pit area at caution speed.
Yeah, and that's going to hurt here as the field will continue. There goes Dusso. He'll serve his penalty this lap. Look at Ranger taking a look on the front straightaway into turn number one side by side.
Alex LeBate led lap number one. Andrew Ranger says that's enough. Drives to the inside in corner one. LeBate tucks right in behind.
Now remember, a year ago, Andrew Ranger led this race early on, but Kevin LaCroix got by him in the on the second lap, so very early going, and Ranger let him go, but then he couldn't catch him back up. This year, Ranger has different plans.
And Patrick Dusso just finishing his drive through pit road. Let's tell you what we mean. There he goes to the inside of Clute, not quite to the start-finish line. Dave, they're going to catch that almost every time.
And that was four wide. What a land rush start. And there you saw Peter Clute in the background going sideways.
Let's go on board. He did get a great run, but that's a no-no. Down into the corner, four wide momentarily, and then contact with Gary Clute.
It's hard when you're a driver to lift when you have that good of a run. There he is on the inside.
Alex Tagliani, that's a tough move on the outside of that corner because the hairpin takes so long to get through. Hard to keep that momentum, but a good clean start otherwise.
Good look at the Spectra Premium 04 of JF Dumoulin. He's riding in eighth spot just ahead of the Castrol Edge Dodge of DJ Kennington. Now Jason Hathaway in the Ray Best is three, holding down 10th.
One thing I find curious, we've been on board three or four race cars now. Everybody has a different shifter and a slightly different position. All driver preference, right?
Well, remember at Canadian Tire Motorsport Park in race number one, Jason Hathaway actually lost his shifter knob during that race and was hanging on to the bare rod.
It looked like Kerry Mix right off the racetrack there. That'll cost him some positions. Managed to keep it out of the tire wall.
Kennington in the Castrol Edge Dodge number 17, tucked up on the back bumper of the Spectra Premium 04 of JF Dumoulin. We've talked about how Spectra Premium is getting involved with NASCAR, designing a radiator specifically for the Pinty series. And essentially, Dumoulin is the test driver for that new technology.
Always wonderful to have new companies on board. And it was great to have Serge Gannett out at the racetrack for a Spectra Premium. He was one of the fellows that did the command to start engines this afternoon.
And we should mention for the next race, talking about DJ Kennington, Jason White, all the way from BC, will haul, make a run at the Toronto Indy Race, the Pinty's Grand Prix of Toronto. He'll be driving a DJ Kennington prepared car. So a good ride for Jason White coming up next race.
I love all the races we go to, Dave. The Toronto Indy is one that I circled on my calendar. I'm really looking forward to getting back to Toronto.
Circuit ICAR, not really known for a lot of tight racing, but it's proving to be a pretty decent fight. Little deeper in the field here between Dumoulin, Kennington, and Hathaway is in there too, as you see the front of the field starting to get stretched out just a little bit.
Yeah, the top five or six have separated themselves, then from about eighth on back, at the back of the pack, a couple of drivers really making their move. Caden Lapcevic fighting back from a rough start, and Patrick Dusso was almost caught back up to the pack.
And if you're just joining us, you can find out where your favorite driver is running with a ticker across the top of your screen. We can tell you that Andrew Ranger continues to lead after taking over top spot on lap number two over Alex LeBate. Fecteau is in.
The 77 of Jocelyn Fecteau needs a bit of fixing after a touch in turn number one. Touch between the number 77 and 71 of Patrick Dusso.
And you can see wrestling with the hood. The hinges all broken there. Some racer's tape going on the front fender, and looks like Fecteau will be there for a little while.
It takes more than a minute and a half to get around Circuit ICAR, so they have some time. Get the hood taped down. They could actually get him out still on the lead lap or in a good position to get the free pass should we get a yellow flag.
Look at how cool and calm your race leader is. Andrew Ranger paces the field in the Ecko Unlimited 100. Welcome back to Circuit ICAR, and there are issues on the Team 3 red entry of Jason Hathaway as he was running in the top 10. Clinton?
Well, big problems here for Jason Hathaway in this Chaco Authentics number 3 car. They've broken the left rear axle, so when the car tries to go through the turns, it's pushing to the left because the right drive wheel is forcing it to that side. They've got to replace this axle so they can get equal drive down the straightaway, or else the car is going to push to the left for the rest of this event.
And Dave, really, it makes the car undrivable with just one drive axle. And Jason Hathaway looked forward to this race, said today's the day we can get out of our slump. They haven't started the season well.
Well, you can say that again. He's had bad luck after bad luck so far in the 2016 season. One driver's having good luck so far today is that man, the 27 of Andrew Ranger. The 32 of Alex LeBay, though, keeping him honest.
You know, what Kevin Lacroix did last season really changed the game on how these no pit stop races are run. Kevin Lacroix was a rabbit, and everyone said, no way can he keep the pace he ran last year. Well, he did, and he won. Now you have to adapt. You have to be able to run that speed the whole race as though there may not be a yellow, because Dave, we saw last year there might not be.
Yeah, and look at who he beat last year, the master here at Circuit ICAR, Andrew Ranger, coming off winning three straight, and he was the one who couldn't catch Kevin Lacroix. So it was the student beating the master last year, but the master is back in control here in 2016. A look at a fight a little bit deeper in the field as Eli Arsenault looks underneath the 18 of Alex Tagliani.
A unique spot to try to make a pass there going into turn number 15. It didn't work out for him quite right.
Battle for fourth spot. Tagliani will hold on to it into turn number one. But Adam, we talked about this a little bit. It's a difficult track to find a solid place to pass. Obviously, turn number one's the best place to pass here.
I would say you're right, Dave, but if anybody knows the tricks of the place, it's Eli Arsenault. Nobody's had as many laps around ICAR as Arsenault, whose family owns the facility.
And he is a driving instructor here at the Mirabel Quebec Airport Circuit. Good luck at Simon Dion-Vienne in that battle. There's the 40 of David Michaud. You saw your points leader, the 76 of Caden Lapcevich, the red car with the yellow numbers, and that's a battle for 11th spot.
I was going to say, that's 11th on back, and they've been like this lap after lap. Caden closing in. He hasn't quite found the spot he needs to make the pass, but I believe he's faster than the cars in front of him.
Solid run, though, for the 95 of Anthony Simone, just ahead of this group. He's sitting in 10th spot in the Innovative Plumbing Supply Dodge.
We ride on board with Caden Lapcevich and a unique track surface. This is an airport course. It's concrete. Everything about this place is different for 16-year-old Caden Lapcevich.
Gary Mix in there, too, in the Avenue Auto Parts 02. There is Tagliani and Eli Arsenault. They're going to go at it a few more laps as Arsenault chasing Alex Tagliani, who sat on pole one year at the Indianapolis 500. Sat on pole here at Circuit ICAR, and now he's struggling to keep the 0-3 behind him.
And this is the closest battle we have within the top 10. Everybody else spread out, running a fast but comfortable race pace as Arsenault smokes the left front tire down into turn one.
Nobody's really relaxing here. Again, we talked about it off the top. It's a sprint race. You have to go, and that's exactly what Eli Arsenault is doing.
This weekend has been absolutely peculiar. Seven drivers were under the track record, Dave, that was set back in 2013. Alex LeBay broke Ranger's record by a full second. That doesn't happen.
No, it doesn't, and if you think about it, no major changes to the cars in the offseason last year, so it's just driver talent, crew preparation, making the cars go faster. You see the 40 of David Michaud having a really great run. He's tucked right inside this battle, just outside the top 10, and Peter Kloot goes to the inside of Simon Dion-Vienne.
And Dion-Vienne trying to pinch Kloot down. Kloot would have nothing of it. They're still side-by-side and sideways through the next turn, but Peter Kloot gets the advantage.
And a veteran of the vintage road course racing in Canada is Peter Kloot. He is a car guy. He knows everything about cars, and he loves to drive them fast, and he's showing just how fast he can drive them here today.
Looking back at the 40 of David Michaud, the reason this is an impressive run for him, Dave, he didn't get any practice yesterday. He came in optimistic this weekend, and the mechanical problems in technical inspection kept him off the track for virtually the entire practice.
Good look at Gary Kloot, who's coming. You saw the nose of that blue and white number 59 as he gained some ground on this little battle here. So as these two try and find lines to hold each other off or pass each other, the 59 is coming.
Gary Kloot is definitely closing in. I believe Eli Arsenault a little bit faster than Tagliani in front of him, but Tagliani's a gifted road racer. He's not giving him any opportunity.
But Andrew Ranger back out on front. If he had a cruise control button, he'd be hitting it right now. Set and ride. That's exactly what Ranger is doing at the front of the field here at Circuit ICAR. To the fourth round of the 2016 NASCAR Pinty Series on TSN. I'm Dave Bradley, along with Adam Ross, Clinton Jeffrey, and Tanya Vaudanville trackside. And it's 27-year-old Andrew Ranger from Roxton Pond, Quebec, who leads 23-year-old Alex LeBay from Victoriaville, Quebec, as we work lap 11 of 30.
Beautiful view on board the Kevin LaCroix number 74. As we said earlier, we've got a few different angles. The leaders, Dave, kind of getting away from him.
Yeah, I think LaCroix thought he was going to do better here today. Of course, he dominated last year's race here at Circuit ICAR. Right now, he's still sitting in third spot, so he's not doing poorly, not by any means, but the leaders are starting to get away.
Well, we touched on it earlier. Seven drivers under the track record, and the top two were a full second under the track record. It's not that LaCroix's gotten any worse, but the competition has really stepped up their game.
And there's a good look at Simon Zion-Vienne, the 37, currently in 15th. One driver who is four laps down back out on the racetrack is Jason Hathaway, and Clinton's with his crew chief.
We're here with Craig Masters. Craig, crew chief for Jason Hathaway. Looked like you guys had problems in the rear end or a broken axle. What's the story on the three car?
Our bad luck continues here. Yeah, we broke a left rear axle and sheared the drive plate off. So put it all new on. He's out there now. So hopefully we can just gain some points somehow.
7 minutes to change that, Adam. That is pretty quick under race conditions.
That is pretty impressive as we ride with Jason Hathaway, who's getting married to the team manager, Jamie Hackinson, in the next couple of weeks. So congratulations to them and their son, Hudson.
And there goes Kevin Poitras in the Pilati number one underneath the 0-2 of Kerry Mix, as now Poitras will take up the challenge on the 42 of Peter Klug.
And ahead of them, you're looking at 10th place on back. Anthony Simone still in the 10th position and 11th on back. They've been battling all day.
Look at the 76. Keen Lapsevich came into this race as your points leader. Got caught up in a little melee in turn number one. Managed to keep it straight, but he lost a number of positions. He is making his way to the front.
He's basically back where he started from, Dave. He started in 15th. He's back running around 15th, but he's worked pretty hard to get there.
Good look at the beautifully wrapped number 95 of Anthony Simone in the Innovative Plumbing Supplies Dodge. There's Peter Klute, the Epic Racewear number 42, and there is your points leader. Flash of the yellow numbers of Caden Lapsevich.
As the field streaks by, we go on board the number 71. This car owned by NHL legend Patrice Brisebois, driven by Patrick Dussault in the 71. Dave, he qualified seventh. He was the last driver to break the previous track record. But you want to hear something interesting about his qualifying run? They only practiced on old tires. When he went out and qualified, he had to change the gears that he ran certain corners in because he had never driven with so much grip in the race car. So on the fly, he's changing the way he drives, and he went under the track record. That's impressive.
That is very impressive, and where he ended up qualifying, also impressive for the driver of the 71 as we ride on board. The number 74, the bumper-to-bumper total lubricants Dodge of Kevin LaCroix. Watch him at work. Now, you can't see his eyes because of the tinted visor, but I love watching their heads, how far they look into the corner, the drivers, when they're going around here at Circuit ICAR.
The gap between Andrew Ranger and Alex LeBay closing just a little bit. And Dave, I have to believe, you have to be focused anywhere you go to drive a race car. But at ICAR, where you're very limited on the visual references, this track is flat as a pancake, and everything looks the same as far as the horizon. You've really got to be on your game to not miss your marks.
Well, you look at some of the other circuits that we do in the NASCAR Pinty Series. Canadian Tire Motorsport Park has elevation changers. Circuit Trois-Rivières has different banners up on the wall, so the drivers know where they are, specifically on the racetrack. Here, you can almost get lost. LeBay now under a second behind your race leader. As you can see, the gap is down to about two car lengths, first to second.
LeBay doing a great job. It surprised a few people. In fact, I think it even surprised Alex LeBay that he put that car on the pole. They knew they were good, but they also know that this is kind of Andrew Ranger's house.
Yeah, this is his playground. But you know what? Alex LeBay has really had a great start to the season as far as qualifying goes. Sat on the pole at Canadian Tire Motorsport Park, of course, picking up his very first win at Autodrome Chaudière in our last event.
And look at fourth, fifth, and sixth. Still in the same order, still with a bit of daylight between them. Tagliani in the EpiPen 18. And Eli Arsenault in the 0-3. That's an interesting story as well, Dave.
Isn't it? A number of teams on their way to Autodrome Chaudière stopped by here, tested their road course cars. Eli Arsenault wasn't doing anything. He dragged his out of storage and started going very quickly. So he thought, maybe I'll race. And here he is running inside the top 10. Andrew Ranger continues to lead.
Kevin Poitras pulls the number one car here into pit lane. They've got issues on the left front and bodywork on the left side of the car also. They're gonna have to fix up the bodywork. Tough break for Poitras here in the Pilati number one.
And Kevin Poitras was racing hard side by side with the 76 of Caden Lapcevich. Let's take a look at what happened. Peter Klude in there too in the 42. There's that contact.
I think Kevin went to close the door. Peter Klute got by and he went to close the door and Lapcevich had already filled that spot.
You saw the Pilati Ford of Kevin Poitras actually hop up in the air as the two sort of caught wheels. Caden Lapcevich, though, continues on. Poitras making a quick pit stop. We stay under green, though. Ranger continues to lead. The 32 of Alex LeBay holding down second. We ride on board your third place driver of Kevin Lacroix.
Shoots that corner. Did you hear the chattering there, Dave?
Yeah, a little bit of wheel hop as Kevin Lacroix went back down through the gears, downshifting on the Total Lubricants Dodge. There's the 18 of Tagliani and the 03 of Eli Arsenault.
And Eli Arsenault, we just talked about, had that great practice session, but the car wasn't up to snuff. A few changes have been made to the NASCAR rulebook, so there was some work needed to be done on the car. Enter Brandon White, who had a full-time team last year. We haven't seen much of him this year. The call went out to Brandon White to prepare that 0-3 car. Great to see him back at the racetrack, and a great job by Eli Arsenault. Wouldn't it be nice to see Arsenault get to the checkered flag at his home track?
Yeah, believe it or not, he has yet to finish one of these races at Circuit ICAR. Good look at the 59 of Gary Klute closing the gap on his back bumpers. We're just over halfway, lap 18 of 30.
It amazes me that these three cars, some of the best drivers our series has to offer, and none of them can close any ground on the other, Dave. They've been like this for laps.
Well, one of the drivers we've been watching since the drop of the green is the 76, and he's had his work cut out for him. Glinton is in the point leader's pit.
Well, we're here with Jeff Lapcevich, crew chief and father of the point leader. Jeff, it's been a pretty good day for you guys. Good battle with Klute out there. What's he saying on the radio?
He's not saying much. Caden's not much for words when he's racing, but actually we got somebody spun on the first lap and he got stopped there and went all the way to the back, so he's climbing back up. I think we're back just outside the top 10 now, so he's having a really good race. He's getting faster and everyone else slowing down, so Caden's doing a great job. Just got a little setback at the start.
Solid day for the leader here. Things didn't get off to the best start, but they're making up for it now.
And Jeff Lapcevich is one of his best cheerleaders, Caden Lapcevich's best cheerleaders. And that is one thing that Caden does well. He picks up speed over the course of a race.
He certainly does. And this being a place he had not come to before, Caden studied a great deal of video before he came to ICAR. As much as he could get his hands on, he wanted to learn everything he could before he strapped in and actually drove out there on the racetrack himself.
Now to the inside of the 95 goes Caden Lapcevich. They're side by side and make contact as they touch tires, heading towards the stripe, a battle for 10th spot.
And Samodi didn't cut him any slack, kept him pinched off tight. Caden follows him into the corner, shades to the inside of turn number one. Little bit of a rub exiting the corner.
Trying to loosen up that 95 on corner exit. We need to tell you that if the race ended right now, Caden Lapcevich would be knocked down to second on the points chart. Andrew Ranger would take over the lead, and Alex LeBay would sit in third.
Well, his main competitor in the points battle, Andrew Ranger, has led every lap since lap two.
Still in the shadow of the 95 is the 76 of Caden Lapcevich, looking for that good place to pass here at Circuit ICAR. 16 turns, total of 2.13 miles, and Lapcevich with a run here.
And Lapcevich is one of the only drivers who's attempted to make a pass in certain parts of the racetrack. A lot of drivers just wait till they get to turn one, the hairpin corner, and they'll drive in as hard as they can and try to make the pass there.
Talking about driving as hard as he can, we're working lap 22 now, or just over lap 21. And these drivers started on these tires. They must be getting worn out.
They certainly are. We mentioned earlier Patrick Dussault racing on new tires in qualifying, and he ran so well. One thing he said, because there's a driver who's raced sports cars and open-wheel cars. He's raced a lot of race cars in North America and in Europe. He said, these cars have so much grip on fresh tires, but the fall-off is unbelievable.
Yeah, it's about two or three laps, and that's pretty much the good comes out of those Goodyear Eagles. But look at this dice at the front. Here comes LeBay and the Can-Am Kappa number 32. The Ford Fusion is on the hunt.
And Andrew Ranger looks as though he's having trouble keeping the Mopar number 27 pinned to the bottom of the racetrack. The car just drifting up a little bit, and Alex LeBay getting all sorts of bite in the Can-Am 32.
See him bouncing off the curbs. He lifted the right front tire in the number 32 as he chases the 27 of Andrew Ranger.
And we're getting reports over the radio. NASCAR officials monitoring the racetrack for possible debris.
No caution yet as we continue under green, but look at that. It's down to about a car length now. Your leader, Andrew Ranger. Alex LeBay into turn number one. That's the best passing spot on this racetrack, and LeBay not close enough to take advantage.
Nine laps to go. This race has been run entirely under the green flag conditions, and Alex LeBay closing in on Andrew Ranger. They've opened a huge gap back to Kevin Lacroix, struggling with the lap car of Kevin Poitras.
And that battle, this one in the front of the field, is a great example. And now caution flies. That debris has brought out the caution here in the Ecko Unlimited 100 at Sir Cree ICAR. I was going to say that battle at the front is a good example of a built motor versus a spec motor here in NASCAR.
You're absolutely right. And let's have a look at what's brought out the yellow. The reports are true. The water jug, it looks like it got thrown out of the number 37 car, but that's a significant piece.
Especially if it's full of water, it's pretty heavy.
They're about a foot tall and probably 8 inches around on the front straightaway.
A chance for the drivers to catch their breath as we head into the home stretch here at Mirabel. Race number four of the NASCAR Pinty Series. We're under caution for the first time today. The cars are lining up. They'll start side by side. Clinton is with the man who calls the shots for the 74 team.
Well, we're here with crew chief Don Thompson Jr. for Kevin Lacroix. Don, your driver's running a great race, really saving his stuff. Does he have something here for the end of this one?
I don't know if we do. The bumper-to-bumper dodge, it's a little bit loose today. Kevin's a good driver, though. He's doing a great job. You never know what'll happen at the end.
They've been hanging in this one tight all day. This caution is certainly going to help out the 74 Lacroix.
Well, but let's talk about that a little bit. Of the top two, who does it help and who does it hurt? Andrew Ranger was falling back a little bit.
This doesn't help either of the top two. It helps the second row. It helps the third row. The top two were leading by a mile. They were happy where they were.
And the 32 of Alex LeBay was coming. He had the momentum. As we get set for the restart here at Sir Cree ICAR, the green flag back up, and Ranger will lead him back into one.
Turn one's going to be hairy. Ranger with a great start. Contact between Lacroix and LeBay.
LeBay goes to the outside of the racetrack. Lacroix comes through, and look at Tagliani right crossways with Arsenal.
There's a lot of rubbing back there, and look at the 76 of Caden Lasevich. Three wide to the inside as Andrew Ranger drives away.
LeBay managed to get his spot back, but Lacroix is going to come back on the inside. And Ranger, as you mentioned, opens up that gap as these two battle for second.
Everybody bumping and banging, jostling for position. Now LeBay into second, Lacroix third, Tagliani, Ely Arsenault. They've got themselves single file. One goes around, that's Peter Clute tied up with Anthony Simone.
Yeah, Simone, the other one, the 95 there in the Innovative Plumbing Supply Dodge. He also sits backwards on the racetrack. Another driver has had horrible luck in 2016, but we stay under green. Six laps to go here in the Ecko Unlimited 100.
Looks like both drivers were able to continue. As Gary Clute on the inside of LP Dumoulin in the 47. Dumoulin will try to cross over back to the bottom. They drag race out of the corner, battling for seventh.
And these two have had a history on the racetrack through the years. Dumoulin and Clute, not necessarily the best of friends, but that pass made fairly cleanly past the WeatherTech.ca number 47 of Dumoulin.
With six laps to go in this race, you don't have any friends out there on the racetrack, but if it is someone you particularly might not like, you're definitely going to drop the gloves and do what you've got to do.
And we should mention that Larry Jackson in the number eight, back in the lead lap with a free pass and the one and only caution so far here at Circuit Free ICAR. Five laps to go, that time past the line.
Down through the hairpin, a one and two. Cade Lapcevich has been in traffic almost this entire race. It was battling for 15th earlier. Now he's in the top 10, but still has his work cut out for him.
A couple of drivers having a decent day here today. Inside the top 20, Raymond Gay making his first start as Eli Arsenal contact with the 18 on Alex Danglieni. And look at Kennington and the 17 take advantage.
Well, Arsenal got under Danglieni and overshot the corner, which forced both of them up and off the racetrack. DJ Kennington, a savvy veteran in that 17, drives right on by.
He knew something was going to happen just ahead, and the 17 picked up a couple of spots in one corner.
We were talking about drivers a little bit deeper in the field doing a nice job today. How about the Johnsonville number 9 of Adam Martin? Kept his nose clean so far, running somewhere in the top 20, I want to say around 16th spot or so.
And Clute looking underneath the 18 of Alex Danglieni, slides way track. He won't pick up a spot. As a matter of fact, he'll lose one. And a driver heads down pit lane at Simone. Clinton?
Well, Anthony, Simone pulls in the innovative plumbing and mechanical number 95. Issues on the rear bumper. Crew in here, and they're not going to waste any time. A good number 12 boot to the right rear. Rips that Challenger rear cowl off. And Simone should be ready to roll back out here in just a moment. They're still working on left side damage.
He spent most of the race in the 10th position, now a lap down to the race leaders.
Now, unfortunate for him, but look at this battle between the 17 of DJ Kennington. Now he has company in the 03 of Eli Arsenal.
Patrick Dusso in the 71, still on the charge from that early race penalty. It'll be tough on the outside of JF Dumoulin right there.
He's up to 10th spot now, all over the side and the back of the Spectra Premium 04. Here he goes, trying to the inside. Is he there? Not quite.
Dumoulin's car was all over the place under braking. Did you see it dancing across the racetrack? So Patrick Dusso will tuck back in line and try to pick it up once again, but JF Dumoulin has his hands full.
Speaking of hands full, do you see Dusso working that wheel? He's going full lock right at times on the exit of the corners.
Spoke earlier on about Cade Lapcevich in the 76, one of the only drivers to really attempt a pass in turn number 14. These drivers are just heading up to that corner shortly. Patrick Dusso closing in the way he is. I expect, that's a heavy braking zone with laps winding down. I expect drivers to kind of open the opportunity to take a chance.
There's a good look at your race leader in the Mopar number 27, the Dodge, and the man from Roxton Pond, Quebec. Believe it or not, out of all the races the NASCAR Pinty Series has run on road courses in the province of Quebec, there's been 20. Andrew Ranger has been victorious in 10 of them.
That is unbelievable. And Ranger just went through the corner I was talking about where it's heavy braking, very, very tight, so it's tough to complete a pass unless you out-muscle your opponent and slack them off the racetrack.
Did that caution ever bunch the field a little bit deeper in the field? Three laps to go as Ranger crosses the stripe, and now the rest of the field comes through. He has a 1.2-second lead on the second-place car, the 32 of Alex LeBay. Kevin Lacroix a little bit further back, 3.5 seconds further adrift of your race leader.
Oh, problems for the epic racewear number 42 of Peter Clute. That could draw yellow. He is off the racing surface. We'll have to listen to NASCAR officials and see what they decide to do with less than four laps to go.
And Clute has had a rough day here today, almost around once and then fully around a second time in his first start of 2016 in the NASCAR Pinty Series.
Taglianni up out of the groove there. He doesn't want to open the door. He's got some hungry drivers right behind him as we're on board the WeatherTech 47 of LP Dumoulin.
Dumoulin chasing the 18 of Taglianni and the 59 of Gary Clute right there as well. Clute looking forward to today. As we talked off the top of the show, he wanted to turn his season around right here at Circuit ICAR. Oh, and there's contact.
He turned LP around.
Oh, boys, as we mentioned, these two do have a history.
Well, they've got a little bit more now. LP lost more than half a dozen spots as he gets up to speed just in front of the 0-2 of Kerry Mix.
Boy, that puts LP Dumoulin all the way back to 13th spot. Lapcevich all over the inside of the curbing as the 76 goes by.
Now we ride on board Patrick Dussault in the 71 under heavy braking into turn 14, right on the rear deck lid of the 04 Dumoulin.
Look at this line, though. And you can see in there is the 40 of David Michaud as well. Let's have another look at what happened.
Kloot drives deep into the corner, down to the inside. LP shut the door and Kloot was there. That's tough. That's closing laps racing in a NASCAR race.
Now, you know contact is going to happen. We ride on board Gary Kloot.
That's one of those accidents. On lap one, that accident doesn't happen. On lap 28,
you know, it's a little bit of a Hail Mary. He needed to be a little bit harder on the brakes. Obviously, wasn't quite up to the door, and that's usually where you dictate if you have the spot or not. So those two will sort it out.
His car turned pretty well with LPs on the outside to hold him on the racing line.
Generally does. A good shot of your race leader, the 27 of Andrew Ranger. Now two laps to go here in the Ecko Unlimited 100. LeBay is right there, though. He's not falling back too far.
You know, LeBay had to fight so hard on that restart. It looked like Ranger immediately got back into his rhythm, and LeBay driving as hard as he can, that 32 machine. He is closing the gap, Dave.
He's starting to come now as LeBay trying to put on a late race push as we come up to the white flag lap. Sean Gibbs, the starter from NASCAR, waving the white flag as they head into turn number one.
One more lap, 16 corners to go for Andrew Ranger to pick up win number four at Circuit ICAR.
And you can see the 74 of Kevin Lacroix pretty much all by himself at this point, running in third. That's a great battle for fourth spot between DJ Kennington and the 03 of Eli Arsenault.
Remember, Kennington was running deep in the top 10 early in the race, picked up a few spots when other drivers got off the racetrack, but we haven't seen him give up much all day long.
Listen to your race leader feather that throttle on corner exit, not abusing those rear tires too much as he continues to try and hit his marks on this, the final lap here at Circuit ICAR. You can see Alex LeBay get a little bit crossways.
Both drivers hard on the gas, chasing the tail of those race cars. He's got half a lap to get this done. LeBay way off the racetrack, trying to keep his momentum.
No doubt, a check of the mirror from the 27 of Andrew Ranger. He knows exactly where that Can-Am Ford Fusion is, right behind him.
There's really just one more optimum passing place the rest of the lap, and they're coming right up. They take this big sweeping right-hand turn and then heavy braking.
But this is where Alex LeBay has been pretty good so far today. Is he close enough to make any sort of move? He gets crossways, and that'll zap his run that he was trying to build up. But look, it's about a car length between your leader and second place.
It might take some contact for LeBay to take the win here. Rangers looking good. Comes home a close second. Kevin Lacroix working his way across the line, takes third. Steady Eddie on the road course. Kennington fourth, Arsenault in fifth.
Well, Dave White, what a weekend for this team. You guys had to change a motor. You guys didn't give up. Your second win of the season. What can you say about your driver's performance this afternoon?
My driver's unbelievable. Did a great job, but can't say enough about this team. We all came together, you know, in practice, got our engine changed. The team gives us every resource we need to do this and put this 27 car in front. Got to thank Mopar, John Camilleri. We have some sponsors here this weekend, John Easton. So really thankful and appreciate the opportunity to be part of this team.
What an amazing day for Andrew Ranger here today. The Mopar team gets it done at ICAR.
There's a good look at your Ecko Unlimited 100 winner from inside his office.
Well, here comes Andrew Ranger out of the Mopar Dodge. What an amazing day for him today. He gets the adulation here from the Quebec crowd. The hometown guy gets it done. Andrew, another amazing day for you and this team. Your fourth win here at ICAR. Safe to call you the king of ICAR now. Your second win on the season. Talk about this day's performance.
Actually, I need to thank my team. We have engine problems during the weekend, but we finally win that race. Very happy about my crew, my guys. Everybody worked so hard, and Alex was pretty quick at the end. In the beginning, I was trying to push a little bit hard. I passed him in the corner number one, and I was trying to keep my momentum. And at the end, I started to slide, and he was catching me a little bit by a little bit. But finally, I have another win here.
An amazing performance by Andrew Ranger here in the Mopar team. They're going to carry this momentum through the rest of the year.
Alex, that was really close, and you had to push real hard.
Yeah, it was intense. I mean, we had a really good car. Saved our car a lot. I was right at Mander's bumper, and the caution flag came up for something and debris on the track. Then we had a pretty good run at the end. We're still faster than him, but we got hit a little bit on the restart. Got probably 10 cars back. Went up to get him back, but part of the game, we missed time, but we had a really good car. It's looking good. I'm happy we had a good run today. We got the car to beat.
And a solid points day for Alex LeBay as we take a look at the rest of the top 10. How about Eli Arsenault in fifth? You see Caden Lapcevich coming home in eighth.
Nice run for Patrick Dussault after the opening lap penalty as well to come home with Patrice Brisebois' first top 10 finish.
Let's check in with Clinton again with your third place finisher.
Well, we're here with Kevin Lacroix. Third place day, Kevin. The rookie of the year battle. This is certainly going to help you with that point total. Talk about your afternoon, keeping your nose clean and being there at the end.
Yeah, the goal was to win for sure, like I did last year, but the car was not quite there. You know, you need to have a perfect day to win. You need a perfect car, everything. The car was good for third, so I finished third, and I'm happy with that. It's good for points, and now this year, you know, the goal is to maintain points, good positions, and consistency, so that's a goal, and I'm happy with the third.
The rookie did an amazing job here today to land on the podium. Great day for this bumper-to-bumper team.
And there you see the points. Andrew Ranger takes over top spot. Lapcevich, LeBay, but look at Kennington for fourth.
Kennington in fourth. Larry Jackson takes a hit, knocked out of the fourth spot, all the way down to seventh.
And a tip of the hat to Alex Tagliani. He missed the opening race of the season, still inside the top 10. To the winner goes the spoils here at Circuit ICAR. This NASCAR on TSN telecast has been brought to you by E3 Spark Plugs, born to burn. By Pinty's, making great food fun. By Bennett Golf Cars and Utility Vehicles. Visit BennettGolfCars.ca.
And the champagne gets sprayed on the podium. A great day at ICAR. Next stop, the streets of Toronto.
The Pinty's Grand Prix of Toronto from the streets around Exhibition Place. We'll see you there.
This copyrighted telecast may not be reproduced, retransmitted, or used in any form without the authorized written consent of NASCAR Broadcasting. NASCAR would like to thank all of our fans for your support, and we hope you enjoy today's broadcast.